Hey everybody, Norm from Tested here at Bay Area Maker Faire. Now, I just met this man, Takashi here, who for the past 3 years has been working on a self-solving Rubik's Cube, and it may be the coolest thing in all of Maker Faire I've seen this year. Takashi had time to explain to me how it works. So this is a traditional Rubik's Cube. I can turn it. I'm not a Rubik's Cube solver. But there are algorithms that you can find online that once you know where the position of all of these pieces are, that you can have an order of operations to solve it. And what he's done is put that inside of the cube. So inside of his robot, essentially, is this arrangement. And if you get close, you can see it's a lot of 3D printed parts. There's a microcontrollers for the brains of it. And then the battery right here, a LiPo battery, and 6 servos, one for each side. Now, it isn't just a matter of getting this inside this, because if you break open a Rubik's Cube, it doesn't fit in here, so you have to make custom plates. So even the plates here are a traditional Rubik's Cube, then sanded down, 3D printed mounts, and then what you get eventually is this robot, which, as you can see, looks exactly like a traditional Rubik's Cube. Now, I'm gonna go turn it here and I can then rotate and I'll go turn it a couple times. I could do it maybe a dozen times, even 100 times. There's no camera on the outside. What it's doing is it's recording these rotations for the position. And I thought maybe it's then running it backwards, but it's not doing that either. Once it knows its position, set it on the table and it runs a solve algorithm to then come alive. This is amazing. Wow. It's like magic.
Yay!
Thank you so much. This is one of the coolest things we've seen at Maker Faire. Find more information below on this project, but well done, sir.
Thank you.